originally I was interested in seeing like how people, like if it was more of a nature nurture thing, but eventually it developed into more of what makes people happy. So first I wanted to figure out what happiness was, whether that's being like financially successful or like eating good food or winning at whatever you're doing. And then I realized that all these things contribute to happiness, but it wasn't what truly made people happy. The study of happiness is part of a growing field called positive psychology, which is all about studying the traits in individuals and communities that make them strong and help them to thrive. And it's really been up and coming, because originally most people were more focused on anxiety and depression and what the worst of the mind, but now we're focusing more on what makes us happy. I found that 50% of your happiness can be attributed to your genes and your upbringing. So that everyone has a emotional set point, and that's the level of happiness that you tend to stick at. Even if like you have like a high point in your life or a low point, you still tend to level out towards this set point. 10% of your happiness is attributed to the environment that you're in and your income, like if you just lost your job or other things along those lines. And then the last 40% is attributed to activities and relationships. These are intentional activities that you do that make you happy, that you enjoy. And then I realized that social bonding and having relationships with people is what truly makes people happy. And being a part of a community is what makes people happy. Evolutionarily speaking, people have evolved to be social beings. That's what makes us successful when we work with others. So it's intrinsically rewarding for people to form relationships. I found one example in Okinawa, Japan. They have the largest proportion of people over 100 years old in their population. And there have been lots of studies to figure out why these people live so long and how they're so healthy. And one of the main things is the community that they've built for themselves. In their culture, it's deeply rooted in family and friendship, and they're always all about like meeting the people, like everybody in the community, and partaking in social interactions. When children are young, their parents put them in small groups called moai, and it's a group of friends that they have, and they keep their entire lives. They help each other emotionally and mentally, and sometimes financially, and it becomes a big family. Like every day, all the elders in the island, they get together in different community centers in their area, and they all have tea together, and they talk about their lives, again, bringing together the community. And they have this really cool traditional band that goes out every weekend and plays in a different village. It's only people between the ages of 20 and 30 can play in the band, and so that brings in the younger generation, but then everybody in all the villages, they all come out and they celebrate their culture together, forming relationships. And then I looked into cohousing communities. These are like buildings that multiple families live in together, and they all form one big family. That originated in Denmark, but now it's really increased popularity here. So one thing I really liked about the cohousing community is that it really shows you that you're not alone, and that like there are a bunch of other people that you can talk to and that you can hang out with. How do you become happier? So the one thing that I really like about this is that you shouldn't think of happiness as a thing that you have, more so as a skill that you need to practice. You're not going to wake up every day and say, I'm going to be the happiest person ever, and this is going to be the best day of my life every day, because that's just unrealistic. But if you practice little things like writing down what you're thankful for or giving people compliments, then it's gradually going to increase your emotional set point level, and you'll become happier over time. That's the end of that. So one thing I liked about Genius Hour is now that I get to hear like what everybody else has been researching all year and see what they're interested in. And just so far, it's been really amazing what people are interested in. One thing I didn't really like is that I'm a very structured student. It's so not having the structure to definitively know what I'm doing at all the time, it was a bit difficult. If you want to look more into happiness, there's a really great documentary on Netflix. It's called Happy, and it was really interesting to see like what brings people joy and like all the progression in the field of positive psychology.